into the ultimate art form. These craftsmen and models will take to the stage to deliver a mind-blowing performance. Hello, Anime USA! Who's ready for some awesome costumes and cosplay? First, we have a very talented and dedicated panel of judges who have come here to judge the costumes. First, we have Cass McGran. She is our cosplay guest and a historical costumer, and I'm told she's a masochist for hoops and boning. Shikarius, another cosplay guest, cries over anime. Masochist for rhinestones and anime.
So he's got three chains.
Terumi, magical seamstress girl. Masochist for all that is cute. Makes sure Edwin is here. So first, little house cleaning. We would ask that there be no recording devices or tripods set up in the aisles. It is a fire hazard and need to be out of the way. Can we do that? Can I get a cheer? Thank you. I only have one other rule for you all. These people have put in a lot of hard work and dedication to what they do. There will be no disrespect and there will be clapping and cheering. Am I understood? Then let's get started with group number one. Jay Lynn, master class, title, Passionate Sanctuary. Even though she wants to be a Keyblade Master, Kairi is a princess of heart, a real Disney princess, and it's time she started dressing like one. Now clad in her new gown, she's come to Anime USA on her search for the magnificent, elusive, and ultimately confusing Kingdom Hearts. Even though we still don't know what exactly that is. Here's Kairi singing Passionate Sanctuary.
Thinking of you, wherever you are. We pray for our sorrows to end and hope that our hearts will blend. Now I will step forward to realize this wish. And who knows, starting a new journey may not be so hard, or maybe it's already begun. There are many worlds, but they share the same sky, one destiny.
Number two, we have Taiga-chan in the novice class. Title, Love Charm, Love Song. When the heart of a human boy is fought over by a group of monster girls, one succubus will try anything to get him to notice her. But can't she charm him with her song? Or will he still turn a blind eye to her love? Please welcome Taiga-chan as Kurumu Kurunona from Rosaria Vampire.
Oh,
ladies and gentlemen, Tyga Chan! I have been asked to make one more small announcement. As you saw earlier, the flashing kind of blinded me. No more flash photography. Take all the pictures you want, but no brightness. For group number three, we... Okay.
Okay. You didn't see me. I wasn't here.
And now for a little personal time here at Anime USA. I have a very dark room and some wonderful judges before me. Tell me, how are you enjoying your time at AUSA?
I'm having a fabulous time. It's wonderful.
Fabulous? You would describe it as fabulous. Wonderful. And who are you cosplaying today?
Klefki from Pokemon.
Ooh, all right. Any Pokemon fans in the house? Do you know why you're here yet?
Give me like 5 minutes, I'll figure it out.
We'll probably be ready by then. Ladies and gentlemen, that was personal time here at Anime USA. Please join us again next time. For group number three, we have Scarlet Mafia performing in the master class as Atorexia, the Hollows of Me. There is only so much one can endure at the hands of those who claim to love them. But be it to control power or another being, the mental and emotional strain will take its toll on a person. And even the most innocent can snap, especially when the power to destroy worlds is within them. Scarlet Mafia warns you to watch who you hurt and to join them with Atorexia, the Hollows of Me.
Thank you.
is, oh look, it's a cosplay skit. No, really, that's what they're called, performing in the masterclass. They will be presenting Creatures of the Night, a brief announcement for knowing your ghouls and ghosts and how to deal with them this All Hallows Eve.
That's right, Usagi's a vampire. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah. Just like the vampire in Usagi's book. Usagi's not so sure about the pizza part, but Usagi loves the ice cream part. And I've got a couple of monsters here, and I'm gonna bring them out and I'm gonna tell you how to deal with them, because Usagi's only pretending to be a monster, but there are real monsters out there. I think I have Frankie here.
Come on, Frankie.
This is Frankie. Say hi, Frankie.
I'm not Frankie.
Say hi.
What's going on here? Anyone know?
He's getting a little upset, but don't worry. Nobody panic. Usagi done lots of research. She knows how to deal with this.
Research are we talking about here?
Oh, Usagi watched lots of movies and played lots of video games. Oh, monster!
I'm not.
Usagi knows this monster.
That's quite hurtful, you know.
It's okay. Usagi know how to deal with this monster too.
That game isn't even any good.
What's a pun?
A brain.
Uh-huh. Zombies like brains.
Oh, we would if you had any.
I just gave them to you.
No wonder.
More monsters! More monsters! I told you I had monsters! Usagi knows this one too. Usagi watched all the movies.
You know what's going on here? Because I have no clue. I asked them and they don't know. No clue, but let's see how deep a hole she did for herself. Pirate? Maddie?
Are you serious?
Uh-huh!
What was this?
It's a jar of dirt. Right?
What's she doing?
Digging herself a
glitter.
Very deep hole.
She's not gonna get
Usagi
out of it.
Usagi made it better.
Oh, it's a bit glitter.
Let's see how this.
This one too.
Oh boy.
I know this one too. She's in the back.
A wand.
I don't like where this is going.
Oh my god.
Neither do I. I say we go to
see Usagi watch all of them too, and some of them are really boring
too. Let's see a little bit. Oh, this is getting dangerous.
I'm not a witch.
I think we should go that way.
Yeah.
My witch.
Yes. Avocado Dorito.
Avocado Dorito?
Yes.
She's gonna blow.
That's the spell, right? Avocado Dorito?
Really?
Yeah. You're a witch.
You want me to put this somewhere?
Witches like wands.
Oh, right. Really?
Yeah.
You don't know about cats, do you?
Cats?
Cats. Wait. And I'm not talking as a musical.
As in meow?
Yeah.
If nobody knows this, most dangerous creature of all, super, super, super dangerous, talking cats. But, and I was saving this for Luna, but this is an emergency.
Now what?
So, just to recap, Frankie likes flowers, zombies like brains, ghost pirates like dirt, witches like wands, and cats like yarn. Happy Halloween! And remember, Sailor Moon says, stay safe!
Oh look, it's a cosplay skit. One more round of applause. And one more round of applause. Next we have pancakes for all I care. Before Vegeta and Trunks set out for the hyperbolic time chamber, Bulma decides to prepare the first and last sit-down meal as a family. Pancakes for All I Care presents Poor Trunks.
Trunks, our very first family dinner. It's going to be you, me, your father, and well, you, I guess. Come on, I'll give you romance. Come on, I'll give you paradise. Make your dreams come true. You'll see fancy. Damn it, Trunks! You sound just like your father. What is it, sweetie? Are you going Super Saiyan? Oh my god, you are. Hey, Vegeta!
Oh, you're very Super Saiyan. I'll kill you. I swear to me, I will.
Damn it, Vegeta. Just use the doors. Oh my god. What did you do to your face?
It's called a mustache.
Yeah, that too. But what's with the M?
Are you serious, Earth Woman? When the great Saiyan prince grows his first great Saiyan mustache, he must celebrate with the great Saiyan mustache M on his forehead to help show off his great Saiyan mustache. And for that reason, you see this M on my forehead. Never again will you see this M on my forehead. Not in your lifetime or any... Will F.A., please shut up!
Why am I not surprised? Coming from Pink Batman.
I am a Batman!
Hey, I felt Dad's power level. What's going on?
What's going on is this twerp thinks he can turn Super Saiyan before he even knows how to walk.
No, don't do that! I won't exist if you kill me, I think.
Well, it looks like I'm killing two birds with one stone.
Mom!
Oh, look. The bad man is going to kill a little baby.
You think I won't do it, Bull Moose?
Here comes Vegeta. After getting beaten by a woman, he can now only win fights with little defenseless babies. Oh, he's so tough.
That's not helping.
Don't think you can out-reverse psychology me, Earth Woman. I'm going to annihilate him.
Well, here he is, Mr. Mustache Man.
No!
Oh, so it's back to that again.
Yes!
Careful with me. I'm little.
It looks stupid.
You look stupid.
Shave it off.
Fine.
Well, that explains that.
Are you checking out your own ass?
No. Mom, I'm making sure I'm still okay since my bear has had me on the stove.
I did not put you on that stove.
Well, excuse me for making my family dinner.
But you're just boiling water.
That's how you make dinner. Duh.
Like I've never done this before. Have I ever done this before?
In the future, you just order pizza. If any pizza places are around and weren't blown to bits by the androids? Yeah, a lot of hungry nights.
Well, okay then. Pizza it is. Be right back. Don't be going anywhere now, boys.
Mom! Well, Dad, since it's just the two of us, I never really... I mean, I was wondering if maybe... Nope! Bye!
Damn it, Vegeta!
I was aiming for the other hole!
Don't worry, little guy. It gets better. No. It doesn't.
Ladies and gentlemen, Pancakes for All I Care and Vegeta's Mustache! Hello, and welcome to Personal Time at Anime USA, Part 2. Tell me, how long have you been cosplaying?
Roughly 13 years, far too long.
Tell me, how much have you spent on cosplay?
There's not a word for that.
Tell me, what costs more, cosplay or college tuition?
It's about equal.
About equal. Thank you, that has been Personal Time at Anime USA Segment 2. For group number 6, we have Genevieve's Blue Curls in the Novice Class, presenting Five Nights at Freddy's Anime Edition. Rumor has it that a nearby pizza joint, Freddy's Fredbear's Pizza, is rumored to come alive at night. Afraid for his life, the joint's night guard has requested the help of the eccentric hacker, Edward Wong, and her team to investigate. Unfortunately, her brave and mighty crew were too afraid, and Edward was forced to find new recruits for the job.
Okay, listen up, men. Since Ed's crew are a bunch of lunkheads, Ed's stuck with you two. So this is how it's gonna go down. Blondie, you're in charge of Boom Boom.
Aye, aye, Captain.
And Shorty, you're in charge of...
Shorty? Who are you calling short? You're the one who's barely bigger than Nina.
Me? Ed's not short. Ed's average.
Yeah, average or midget.
Why, Ed oughta...
Enough! I think it's best we split up.
Fine!
Those boys aren't scary. It actually looks kind of cute. In a creepy kind of way. Wait, is that you? Ah, shoot. It's the robot that looks like Ray. Gotta remember the... Oh my god, is that a Mr. Fuzzy Bear? I gotta hug it. Aw, that's cute. He hugs back. Hugging a little too tight there, Mr. Bear. You can get let go now, Mr. Bear.
Breathe.
Help. Help. Somebody. Help. Help me.
Dangerous? Ha. I laugh in the face of danger. What could be scarier than a homunculi? Ah! Ow! Save me! Like I said, not scary at all. Hey, you look like one of Father's experiments. What are you, one of his reject children? Did he make it to the 5-7? Oh, pose off, eh? Alright, bring it. Hey, what gives? I'll teach you. Huh, why isn't it working? no, 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 please, keep back. Ah, ah!
Wow! Where is Ed? Oh, Ed's in the basement, where all the dark secrets are kept. Now, where could they be? Here, secret. Here, secret, secret. Aha, a computer. Computer from days of old, lead me to your access code. Whoa, this is some dark mojo, like really dark. It says here that... Who's there? Ed knows karate. No, Ed's new crew. I'll hack you until you malfunction for this. No, please. Huh? Woo! Saved by daylight. Well, I guess that's that. Oh, before Ed forgets, it's daylight savings time. Better switch the clock back.
And that was Genevieve's Blue Curls! I knew you could do it. Proud of you. Group 7, we have Team 7 Rocks in the novice class presenting Talk Dirty to Me. Now that Naruto's over, Team 7 is hitting the road and tearing it up. As rock stars, welcome to the stage Kakashi, Naruto, and Sasuke!
Konbanwa! You guys ready to rock?
Oh, you know, I never see you look so good. You never act the way you should. But I like it. And I know you like me too, the way that I want you. I gotta have you, oh yes I do. I never ever stay out late. You know that I can hardly wait just to see you. And I know you cannot wait. Me too. I gotta touch you, cause baby we'll be at the drive-in in the old man's Ford behind the bushes until I'm screaming for more. Down the basement, let's set the door and baby talk dirty to me. I gotta hear you, cause baby we'll be at the drive-in in the old man's Ford behind the bushes until I'm screaming for more. Down the basement, lock the cellar door and baby
talk dirty to me.
Sasuke, pick up that guitar. Yeah.
Group 8 doesn't exist. I'm not even joking. Group 8 is a blank page.
Oh my God.
It says Group 8 at the top, but that's it. So,
oh, my group 8.
No more Group 8. Group number 9, Left of West. In the masterclass performance performing Epic Rap Battle of Anime! No one ever said high school was all fun and games, but when it comes to representing your school's clubs, brands, things can get downright dirty. So just which of these clubs shines brighter than the rest? It's the prestigious Ouran Academy's host club versus Otonoki Zaka High School's Idol Club. Who will win in this epic rap battle of anime?